Hi, I'm Mark Pittman, trawler specialist with JMYS. Today I'm in sunny Chesapeake, Virginia aboard Mabuhay, a 2003 Nordhavn 50 flybridge model. She's hull number 25 in the series and powered by a single Lugger 300 horsepower main engine. She's stabilized with NIAT active fin stabilizations and features many other great options. Today we're going to go through the boat and show you exactly everything Mabuhay has to offer. Let's go.
The swim platform features a swim ladder for easy access in and out of the water. There is a staple to help protect you when you're walking back there. There's a barbecue over on the port side. You'll notice there's a large amount of space in this cockpit area, side deck to starboard, a ladder that goes up to the boat deck. The hawse pipes are recessed. There's a warping winch on the back bulwark and a sliding door into the saloon. You can see the boat deck is up above. Again, great access here. Fuel fills for the four fuel tanks. There's another view of the warping winch. And then there's also storage lockers back aft. In one of them, we have the propane locker with a couple of propane bottles. Easy to service. Cockpit connects to a side deck that runs along the saloon. You have the access ladder up to the boat deck there. And as you pass the windows for the saloon, the aft one is fixed on both sides and the two forward ones are opening for cross ventilation. There's a boarding door on the starboard side for dock access, up a couple of steps to the Portuguese bridge, passing the sliding door to the pilot house. As you look forward, you'll see there's a gate that lets you into the foredeck. Good Portuguese bridge here. Looking back aft, the windlass, the hatch, the derade vents, built-in deck box, good view looking aft. Coming back onto the foredeck, some freeing ports, hawse pipes, recessed anchor well, and the windlass with the chain stopper anchors up forward. Portuguese bridge wraps around on the port side and works your way back to a set of steps that takes you up to the boat deck. You'll notice there's good railing as you come up. It's very easy to get up here. And there is your tender mounted athwartship, mounted up high so that the outboard can be vertical. Crane, and looking back aft, the crane and the view back aft. Good amount of space here. There it is with the dinghy launched. You see the mounts, the life sling, a deck box, and the boat deck does connect to the flybridge. So one level, seating area, Todd helm chair, destroyer wheel, good electronics, excellent visibility. And you'll see from this view, this is a wet exhaust boat, and you can see that there's a bimini top with antennas all set up in place. Here's another view of the tender and the outboard. The large sliding door opens up to bring you into the entry level. Saloon back aft, galley forward to port and steps up to the pilot house. Two cornice chairs on the starboard side. On the port side, big bench seating with a table, flat screen TV, natural transition to the galley and up to the pilot house. Notice that the windows are opening forward and fixed back aft. Sliding door back aft to the cockpit. Great visibility in this area. Looking all around, good view of the galley there, Sorel countertops. Coming in, the stove, the oven, the double basin sink, the raised counter to conceal where you're preparing meals, great seating back aft, custom table there, the seating, the overhead handrails, bookcase, refrigeration. From the entry level, it is up a couple of quick steps to the pilot house. Once you arrive at this raised pilot house, you'll be very impressed with the visibility. Great number of windows all the way around. Bench seating back aft and a stid helm chair forward. There's a table there. A stairway on the starboard side down to the staterooms. The doors open outboard on either side for the decks. Up forward, excellent arrangement of electronics, destroyer helm, electrical breakers, and again, the visibility of cross ventilation with opening window, also as well as the sliding doors, back aft seating area, table, and a freezer back aft, and a hatch that will let you pass through goods to the flybridge. Looking through the electronics, Furuno, ICOM, NavNet, as you come across, big display, weather station, windlass, horn, all the controls easy to reach from that Stidhelm chair. Overhead, main engine, wind, depth, NIAD, active fin stabilizers, outback inverter, the stop switches and the MMC control for the main engine, panels on both sides, easy, well-organized. Going down the steps from the pilot house, you reach the lower level, the accommodations deck, and this is a three-stateroom layout on Mabuhay. There are two divided cabins, one on port side, one on starboard side. There is a centerline bulkhead that separates them, and you do have very large bunk beds on either side, an opening port light on either side, hanging lockers. The bunk bed arrangements are mirrored from each other, same combination on the port side as the starboard side, and they share a head and shower forward. Beds can also be used as storage shelves if you're not filling them with people. There are drawers underneath, teak and spruce sole, good ceilings along the sides, and as you can see, easy access up to the head and shower. Bookcases, easy room to get around in, very comfortable for your guests. Looking from the head back aft to the port side, bank of drawers there, there's a mirror there. Again, two large bunk beds. Up top, opening port lights into the Portuguese bridge to give a little more light and ventilation as well. Guest head has some storage lockers in it. There is the shower with a shower curtain, vacuum-flush toilet, Sorel sink counter with a single basin sink, mirrored medicine cabinet, overhead hatch, good size shower, and all the way forward is access to the chain locker right below the ground tackle, the windlass. You can get right in there to get to the chain. Shelves on the side. The owner's stateroom is approached from coming down the stairs. The bed is athwartship, making it very convenient and easy access, easy to make. A lot of white Wilson art formica equivalent in here to make this very light, fresh, airy. Opening port lights, as you can see, a good blend of teak. It's very well trimmed. The engine room door is back aft, and you can get into the engine room there. There's a bureau. The head is behind the large door there. You can see that's the door for the hallway, and now you're into the owner head, Sorel countertop, medicine cabinet, stand-up shower stall. Engine room door is in the owner's stateroom and it has a viewing window. Very easy to take a quick look before you go inside. Make sure everything's clear and then open up the dogged and gasketed door. As you enter, you will notice that it's very clean. There's a lot of gear in here. It's well stored. Of course, your lugger, 6108A turbocharged main engine, back aft on the starboard side, Northern Lights 12 kW generator. On the starboard side, notice the bench area there, the seating area. This is one of the benefits of the Nordhavn 50, is it's very easy to sit in the engine room. Not quite standing headroom, but it's actually more comfortable, I think, to sit down. Stainless rails around the engine, sight glasses outboard on both sides for the primary fuel tanks. Forward to port, where we're looking now, is the NIAD stabilizer mechanics. and there's a big tool chest below that. Along the starboard side, fuel management, raycores, all the valves, supply, return, transfer, another look at the generator, and then across to port is the wing engine. It's a Yanmar 3JH3E, 40 horsepower wing engine with its V-drive, a couple of the strainers back aft. Here's a view of the Northern Lights generator with the sound shield cover off. See how clean that is, how easy it is to service. And then from the back starboard corner, looking forward, there's the door. You can see access to the owner's stateroom. Clean, uncluttered, very simple to get around in. Look how nice the engine is. It's clean and tidy, well looked after. Looking forward, an inverter bypass, fuses, starboard auxiliary fuel tank, big box for batteries. Look outboard, you see some air conditioning. You see the stern thruster button. There's the stern thruster, rudder support, arm, part of the water maker, bilge pump, more air conditioning, the port fuel tank, more batteries in this big box here. I want to thank John Hoffman and Mark Pittman for putting together this video. Did a great job. And Mark, why don't you wrap us up next?
We've had a really great time today cruising aboard Mabuhay here in Chesapeake, Virginia. If you would like more information, please visit our website at www.jmys.com. You can also reach out to me via my cell phone or email address, or you can call Mr. John Hoffman, who's also the co-listing broker. His information will be provided as well. Thank you for visiting us today, and we hope to hear from you soon.
Hey, Trawler friends, thank you for watching the video. We love doing these videos. It's great having you on board. Great being out on the water. We do have over 100 videos on the JMYS YouTube channel. If you would like to subscribe, you can click the button. If you'd like a reminder on when the next video is going to show up, you can click the bell. That'll give you a reminder. We really appreciate it when you give us those thumbs up. Thank you very much for that. We also like your comments. We'd like to respond to your comments. So please keep watching. Thank you for your encouragement. If you'd like to watch some other videos, we have a couple of them over here to click on. And there's always something new coming on the JMYS YouTube channel. Stay tuned and we'll stay in touch. Look forward to watching you and you watching me. Thank you.